Okay. All right. I think I fixed it. Okay. Minor details. All right. So first match is we got Panties playing Cammy going up against Ratchis playing Nikali. So I don't have any... okay. So, yeah. So Panties is... Planes is super platinum, Ratchis is ultra bronze. This is the second round of winner's bracket. We didn't really do anything in terms of seeding this time. So, because we weren't quite sure what the turnout was going to be. Obviously, Ratchis looks like he may be unmatched. Outmatched here. Panties is trained by Flo. He is from... Shoot, I just... Damn. I had the data somewhere. Alright, well, that was... Alright, thanks. Thanks, Panties, for making that so fast. Hold on, let me bring up, I had a whole spreadsheet with like information and everything. Hold on, let me just bring this up again. All right, here we go. All right, so Ratchis goes down to loser's bracket. Stephen Burnham from Washington State goes down to loser's bracket. And Panties is from Canada. He's from Quebec. So, let me just add this here. So just to give you guys a little bit of background. I'll just give you guys a little bit of background while we bring in the next match. So Panties trains with Flo. He came to Flo because he wanted to learn how to play Cammy and how to properly play her. Did martial arts for years, 13 years, but then had an injury, so he had to stop. So now he's been dedicating all of his time and effort to playing fighting games. Specifically, it was I can definitely see the. I can definitely see the correlation between playing, playing Street Fighter and fighting games and doing martial arts. You know, it requires, obviously, martial arts are more physically demanding, no question about that. However, a lot of the same sort of principles apply. Discipline, muscle memory, consistency, practice, dedication, understanding your opponents, all these things come into play. And for those of you guys just joining us, wondering where you can check out the brackets, I'm about to share this with you right now. You can go to challenge.com/CCTtest, all caps. And we're probably going to have to figure out a better way to do that in the future. But let me just put this text. And if you, Nick and Nogaremi, hold on, Nick's. Eric Ellison, Nogaremi, Eric Ellison. Go ahead and get started. This is a good learning experience, guys. This is why we're doing this. Unfortunately, a lot of the stuff is going to be done on the fly because it's hard for me to think more than 5 minutes ahead. All right, so Nikori is Nick Raba. And he is also from Canada, Got a lot of Canadians participating in this tournament. Nick Raba is, I forget what part of Canada he's from. But what I can tell you is that he trains with Alex Myers. And he plays Nash. Actually, he's trained with me once or twice as well. And, you know, I've seen him progress over the past several weeks as we've been running our new video course called Rise Up in Ranked, which you can check out at riseupinranked.com. And Noga Remy, who he's going to be going up against, is Eric Ellison. Started playing when he was a senior in high school. He's trained with Justin Wong, as well as K-Brad.
If you stand in round one, fight.
Very risky fireball right there, you know, and really smart by Nick to jump in straight away. These players on paper look pretty evenly matched. I can tell you for sure that as a Ryu player, it can definitely be a struggle to fight Nash, because Nash just seems to have an answer. Well, of course he has an answer for all of Ryu's fireballs in Nash's V-skill. All right, Eric Ellison, Noga Remy, not going down without a fight here. Oh no, misses his hit confirm, misses a big opportunity to score some damage in the corner. Not really conscious of Nash's ability to just teleport out of the corner like that. So first round goes to Nick Raba. Would have been smarter to have blocked right there or done the late tech. All right, I like the use of meter right there. Again, not really thinking about what the opponent wants. I find that this is very common in the silver to gold ranked players, where they don't really consider what the opponent's resources are and what the opponent wants to do at any given moment. And you can kind of see that a little bit in Eric's play, because okay, that's literally three times in the first game, that Nick has used one of Nash's, I'm not gonna call them like popular, I'm gonna call them obvious options. Nick used one of Nash's obvious options three times over the course of two rounds, and Noga Remy, Eric Ellison, was not really conscious of what, or I would say, okay, because okay, look at the fight is a conversation, and if you're having a one-way conversation with the person, it's not really a conversation, is it? It's more of just one person talking at you, because you're not really listening. Eric is not really listening in this instance, because he's just not considering Nash's options. And Nick looks like he's about to run away with this four rounds straight. Very impressive. Gotta say, I like what I'm seeing. All right, Noga Remy trying to slow down the pace here, playing a little bit more patient, but this is definitely the pace that I think Nash excels at. I mean, he can sit back, throw sonic booms, run away. You know, once you get close to him, he's going to V-trigger out. Or maybe he'll use one bar on V-reversal. Oh, man. Is this guy infiltration? Wow. I can't, you know, it's very rare that you see. Oh, no. That was kind of a waste. It was very rare that you see the bazooka knee used to get out of the corner like that. I only see infiltration do that. And again, either Eric is not looking for Nick to teleport out like that, or he has no idea how to stop it. So one thing that you guys should know about Nash's V-Trigger is that it's not an instant get-out-of-jail-free card. You can hit it in the first two frames, but that means that you have to have an attack out already, basically perfectly meaty, to stuff the to stuff the teleport. And looks like it's about to be lights out here for Eric. Nick just going to town. Uh-oh, there we go. Yeah, that V reversal, not free either. Oh my gosh. Oh, there it was. He hit it. Oh my gosh. He hit the V trigger perfectly meaty. Now it's coming down to the wire. One hit. Oh my gosh. Went in a little bit too hard. Did Noga Remy, Eric Ellison. All right. Well, that was a really close match there. I think Nick Raba was playing with his food a little bit, but he's going to advance to fight Pennies in the winner's bracket. Noga Remy is going to go down to the loser's bracket. He's not out yet, and he's going to be fighting... Ah, okay, awesome. Yes, here, let me just screen share. How about we do that? Ah, yes. Thinking of everything, aren't we? Yes. Sorry, guys. First time doing this stuff, you know, so have a little patience with me. I want to shout out... definitely want to give a shout out to... whoop, where'd it go? Definitely want to give a shout out to Elon, who's been helping to put this tournament together in the background. Elon does a lot of background type work for us here at Cross Counter, and he's done a great job with this so far. You know, we're streaming this on Facebook, so it would be great if we could get some feedback from you guys on what you liked, what you don't like, so that we can make this a better, we can make this better next time. All right, so this is the bracket. Coming up next, we're gonna have Chicago Classico, Juan Sandoval going up against Captain Grady, whose name I just had right in front of me. Captain Grady. David Grady. Who trains with K-Brad. He's in the military, plays Street Fighter V. He's got a basic understanding of Street Fighter V and mechanics. Plays with a group of friends, and he would like to be the best of that group. I like that. Those are very common goals, you know, that we deal with here with cross-counter training. But yeah, as you can see in the loser's bracket, we have two Justin Wong students going up against each other. Unfortunate turn of events there. And yeah, go ahead and ready up one if you're watching. And yeah, so Juan Sandoval is from Chicago, as you may have guessed. And, oops, wrong one. There we go. Oh, shoot, that's me. But yeah, so thank you guys for joining us. If you guys are just joining us here, watching on Facebook, thanks for hanging out a little bit on Sunday afternoon. This is the cross-counter training pilot edition of our student tournaments. This is the first time that we're trying something like this, and so it would be great to get feedback from you guys, because we want to know what we can do better, what worked, what didn't work, and yes. Yeah, these guys are... Oh man, we really got to improve our messaging, because some of the guys in the tournament, weren't in the group. All right, so.
Round one.
Okay, not quite. All right, okay, so. Juan is a Urian player. He used to play on a big fancy HD TV, as I'm sure a lot of you do or did at some point, but recently has upgraded to a gaming monitor and has found many improvements to his game in terms of reactions and execution and everything ever since. He's one of the students that we've been working with the Rise Up in Ranked video course. David Grady, I know significantly less about. But I know that he's trained with K-Brad. And I know he's from California. So, alright, let's talk about the match. So, right now, both characters, very dangerous. There we go, yep. This should be game. Oh no, 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 no. Okay, you know, one of the things that we really like to preach here at Cross Counter Training is the importance of proper meter utilization, right? So burning one bar on EX Fireball to end the round instead of using a shoulder tackle to gain meter instead of burn meter. I mean, this, you know, this is not advisable, guys. Also, Juan has this bad habit of burning all his meter on things that don't necessarily matter, such as that EX tackle, the EX knee drop. Yeah. I mean, you know, your meter is your money, guys. And if you think about it that way, I'm sure you could find that there are lots of instances of the parallels between the way that you spend your meter and the way you spend your money. Are you going to the club every Sunday or every Friday, every night of the week, balling out, bottle service, big tipper, going to the clubs, you know? Then you might be the type of person that spends all of his meter at the end of round one, and they don't have any for round two. Are you living paycheck to paycheck? Be honest with yourself. Or do you never spend any money at all? You always say you forgot your wallet, never pay for shit. You might be the type to hold on to your meter for that perfect moment, and then you're dead before the moment happens. Because just like money, your meter is energy, resources. And if you never spend your meter or money on things, then you just live or die with the meter, with the money in the bank. Who cares? You're still dead. If you die with full bar, full V gauge, full critical gauge, you are still dead, my friend. All right. So, Captain Grady right there, Mr. David Grady from California. Okay, gets himself out of the corner. I don't like that follow-up, even though it worked. Oh man. Okay, so now I predict that Juan is going to put V-trigger out. Oh, maybe he's not. Oh, there it is. Okay, I like it. Oh no, puts him out of the corner. Okay, back in the corner. Okay, so what most players don't know, because Urian is still kind of new, is that forward medium punch is +2. So if you see him reach out like that, you need to hit a button. Oh no, misses the opportunity to end it with a crush counter. That EX headbutt is immensely unsafe. Oh no, wasn't prepared for the counter hit right there. That standing medium punch on counter hit can link into crouching medium punch, which you could then follow with standing leg kick into some sort of tackle of your choosing. But a couple of missed opportunities there. But Juan looks like he's about to run away with this one. Oh, wow. Did you guys see that? If you guys aren't quite sure what Urian's V-skill does, it gets him one hit of armor for his special moves, aside from the fireball. So that means that you could use the headbutt as anti-air. And it looks like all Juan has to do is hold it together. Not do anything too crazy. All right, so David Grady is going to go down to the loser's bracket. And Juan advances, and he's going to be playing the winner of the next match, which is going to be Trillionaire versus Loco. All right, good stuff, guys. And if you guys are just joining us, then this is the very first cross-counter training student tournament. And definitely want to thank everybody who's been part of it so far. All right, so yes, Trillionaire. Let me tell you a little bit about Trillionaire. Philip Booker, who I believe was from New York, if I'm not mistaken. Hold on, let me bust this open. Oh no, I'm sorry. Trillionaire is Philip Booker from Sacramento, and he's gonna be going up against Logan Co. Loco. You see what he did there? Get it? And Logan is also from California. He trains with Broly Legs. And Philip Booker has trained with me a couple of times. Oh, okay, here we go. Darn, you know, we really should have asked what rank these guys were, but, you know, I guess that's just something that we're going to ask later on in the future.
Devour round one. Fight.
All right, so Logan playing Macho Man Randy Zangief, and Phillip's been playing Nikali, certainly one of the strongest characters. And but I will say that even though Zangief is widely considered to be one of the weaker characters, if Philip Booker, Trillionaire, plays the matchup properly and uses all of Nikali's tools, such as his V-skill, to keep Zangief out, unfortunate. Yeah, so what you guys need to understand about Zangief is that he actually, off of the light SPD, he doesn't get anything afterwards. Like, he's minus two if you try to dash up. So that means if you're minus two after the dash off of a throw like that, that means that all you can do is dash forward and block. If you hit a button and they hit a button, as you saw Trillionaire do, their button will score a counter hit, as you saw, and then, you know, they'll be able to cancel into V-Trigger. Oh my gosh, but on EX SPD, it is true. Oh my gosh, you definitely get a setup after that. Uh-oh. But Logan might just be outmatched here. He does have V-Trigger. Oh, I really wanted to see a cancel into V-Trigger right there. Uh-oh, this could be curtains for Philip. Trillionaire on the run. All Logan has to do is oh my gosh, all he had to do was stay away. I mean, you know, like, in that situation, right, 50 seconds on the clock, you got a big life lead, you only need one hit, there's really no reason to go in so hard, because when you do, things like that happen, right? I mean, I don't know if you guys are playing on PS4, but we are definitely playing online here. And if you don't keep the distance, as well as start to run the clock. The clock, the timer is a resource. And he had plenty of time and plenty of life. But all it took, as you guys saw, was one opening from Nikali in order to change and steal that round. But I'll tell you what, I do like Logan's use of anti-air down fierce right there. Oh my god. It just seems, it's like on paper it shouldn't work, but in real matches that sequence is just so effective. But yeah, Logan's got a good life lead here. All he's got to do is stay patient. He can flex on him. So if you guys aren't too familiar with the way that Zangief's flex works, I know personally I wasn't. And I was tired of losing to this guy. But basically the V-skill can absorb two hits. And you just hold it down and then he's walking. It can absorb more hits in V-trigger. But oh, there's one. And then you can let it go. Oh no, he didn't actually think that the jump and medium kick was going to hit. And thus, EX SPD whiffed. For those of you guys that are new to the game and you're not quite sure why stuff like that happens, no, it is not a glitch. In fact, you cannot be grabbed, whether it's a regular throw or a command grab, cannot be grabbed while you are in hit stun, such as, and hit stun is the state of when you are either taking damage or blocking. Well, I guess that would be in block stun. You can't be thrown when you're in hit stun or in block stun. And Logan here is just falling apart. Not looking good here. Definitely one of the hardest characters to win with, I will say. I mean, personally, I recommend that all of my students, that they play Ryu until they reach competency. I mean, why make things hard for yourself? You know, when you're first learning the game, you know, there's so much going on. Stick with a character that's tried and true. They built the entire franchise around Ryu. Oh my gosh. All right. So Trillionaire takes that one pretty convincingly for two straight games. And he's going to be going up against Juan Sandoval, Chicago Classico, in the next round of the winner's bracket. In the meantime, we're going to be going down to the loser's bracket. We're going to see what's going on down there. And it looks like we're going to have Broly's... All right, so this might be something that we have to... Okay, hopefully... Well, that's kind of weird. Okay, never mind. We're just going to keep on going with winner's bracket. Okay, cool. I like that better. So generally, if you lose a match... in winner's bracket, you don't want to play your loser's bracket match right away. So hopefully we don't get... okay, never mind. We're going to round three winners. Okay, no problem. So, yeah, if you lose a match in winner's bracket, you definitely don't want to play your loser's bracket right away because you're likely still going to be on tilt. So you want to try to, you know, bide your time as much as possible. So. All right, let's talk a little bit about prizes. What are these guys going to get? Well, I'm glad you asked. Let me just open this up. There we go. All right. Ah, yes. Okay. So, prizes. First, second, third. First place, the winner gets a 4-session package with the trainer of their choice. Second place gets one free training session with the trainer of their choice. Third place gets a 6-month subscription to CrossCounter.tv where they can access shows like Excellent Adventures as well as a bunch of personal training sessions as well as the Rise Up in Ranked video course. And 4th through 8th place get a free 3-month subscription. So we got some pretty good prizes. I mean, yeah, you know, like, I will admit we don't have tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of dollars on the line like Capcom Pro Tour. But it's not about that today, ladies and gentlemen. It is about training and getting better. It is about unlocking your potential. That's what we're doing today. So, our next match is going to be the Battle of Canada. That's right. It's going to be Panties going up against Nikori. Panties is from Montreal, Quebec. Panties trains with Flo. Nikori was trained by Alex Myers, although I've trained with him once or twice, and he is also part of the Rise Up in Ranked video course. So he's actually, I actually think that this is going to be a good match. I think Panties has a slight edge based on what I've seen from him in that first game, but you know, who knows? Maybe. I think Nick has been putting in a lot of work these past several weeks, because he's been in all of the group training sessions that we've been doing in the Rise Up in Ranked training group. So, yeah, I mean, looking at it on paper, I mean, Panties definitely has the advantage on paper. Panties looking super strong here. I mean, if he wins this, yeah, if he wins this, it could be. Yeah, it's gonna be the winner of this goes into semifinals. Might be a little bit of lag here. Canadian internet, I don't know. I would expect. Ooh, all right, Nick, off to a good start right here. Oh no, misses the. Oh, it's just running away. Okay, I'm a little confused, but three uppercuts in a row, not too often you see that. All right, so Nick has got a good lead right here. Good activation by Panties right there. Wasn't able to convert into major damage. Oh, and wow, nice trade right there with the bazooka knee. This looks like the end of round one for Nick. Ends it with the overhead smart stuff. I like what I'm seeing. I don't know if you guys can tell, but Nick has definitely been putting in the work. Ooh, wow. Both of them going for crush counter straight away at the top of the round. Nick on the verge of getting stunned right here. All right, runs away, lets the stun gauge wither away. Now, he's got a lot of work to do. Good blocks right there by Panties. Really tricky side switch, but not tricky enough. Nick looks like he's a little bit out of ideas. He does have a lot of bar to work with, but the thing is, even if he were to land like a full combo, oh, into super right here. Nope. Okay, chooses not to use it. I like that he wanted to save it. He's got to be very careful though. Oh yes, Panties drops the combo. Oh my gosh. All he's got. Oh my gosh. Okay. Well, you know, it's actually could have gone either way right there for a moment. Now it's going to be Nick having a slight meter advantage here and going into round three. Oh no. Nick, definitely not where Nash wants to be. No bar. I mean, sorry, no V reversal. In the corner, makes his way out. No anti-airs. Panties getting a lot of mileage off of these jump-ins. Oh no, it looks like Panties is getting a little impatient, using all of his bar on the hooligan. Oh no! Nick hits the panic button. It gets him out, but now he is out of resources. He's gonna need to do something to at least try to get. Oh, it's done. Yep, that was it. Okay. Yeah. Oh my god. Okay, well, it worked. Uppercut? Of course. Of course. Yep. So, like, let's think about that for a second, right? I mean, Panties had his back to the wall. He had lost control. Nick hit a very crucial V-trigger combo, and you know, maybe it was not the safest thing to do, obviously, but, you know, the onus is kind of like on Nick to know that he's likely to hit the panic button and uppercut right there. I mean, he risked it all. Now, clearly Nick is still thinking about what happened last round. Meanwhile, is about to be stunned. Okay, nope. Drops his combo. I would say he's still slightly on tilt. And I think Panties is running away with this one. Nope. Okay, please crush counter punish this dude. Very tricky non-cross up right there. I like it. Oh, see, that time. So he put the fear into him. Panties did in that first game. Like right there, you could see it was almost the same situation where Nick had another opportunity with Panties in the corner, but he was too afraid and he didn't want to uppercut. Or sorry, he thought he was going to uppercut and thus did not want to attack. You know, smart stuff by Panties to uppercut in that situation, because Nick is still reeling from the effects of that uppercut. This is match point for Panties. He is one round away from going, advancing into winner semifinals. But he is all out of resources now, but it's not gonna matter. Game over. Nick gets sent to loser's bracket. Nicely done by Panties, showing the true power of training with Flo. And looks like we're gonna have, next up, we're gonna have Chicago Classical Juan Sandoval from Chicago going up against Philip Booker, AKA Trillionaire, from Sacramento, California. Beautiful city. Got to visit two times this year, once for NorCal Regionals and once for Wizard World. So many friends up in NorCal that I miss dearly. Alright, so it looks like, Juan is going to be playing Urien. Trillionaire Philip Booker is going to be playing Nikali, I would imagine. Definitely an interesting match, because I think Nikali is used to being in control, used to running all over his opponents, getting away with all kinds of tackles and wake up jabs in a V trigger. But I'll tell you what, guys, Urien actually, I think, is one of the few characters that can go heads up with Nikali. Yeah, that's right. I thought, as soon as I saw Urien and Nikali both tackle at the same time and saw Urien win, I thought, yes, finally, justice. Here is a character that can, and you know, actually, even in the story, Urien talks shit so much to Nikali, calls him a savage, said you should have joined me, now I'm gonna destroy you. I like that, man. This is a character that I really, even after all this time, I still feel like I connect with, so. Oh, I see. Trillionaire says, shh, I'm actually broke. Uh-huh. Well, if you win this tournament, Philip, then, you know, you're going to have a sweet training session, four-session training session package. And thanks to you guys for joining us. Please post some comments, feedback, whatever you think could make this better. This is, you know, we're beta testing this. Hopefully we can offer this as a service. It's one of the things that we do here at Cross Counter Training. All right, pretty even so far. We'll see what he does on Wake Up. Of course, the classic. Oh no, okay, well, Juan makes his way slightly out of the corner. Both of these guys playing very conservatively. A lot on the line here. because this match advances them to semifinals. I would like to have seen the use of V-reversal right there. Otherwise, you're just going to die in the corner. Yep, die in the corner with full V-trigger. And then Nakali starts. See, although Philip is broke, Trillionaire says he's broke, he's definitely done a good job of saving his meter. Now, let's see, he's got a lot of bar to work with. Okay, there we go. Good damage right here. Nice punish. Tackle for medium punch. Yep, okay, good. Still got a stun gauge to worry about. All right, random tackle. Maybe not so random after all. Stun gauge slowly dwindling. All right, the situation is over. Situation reset. Back into the corner. Oh, no, Philip Booker on. Okay, well, that was obviously not the best punish. Shame on you, Juan Sandoval. I can't believe... Oh my god. After... It was done. It was done. I'm so fucking mad right now. Oh, Jesus. Don't get hit by that, guys. It's not that good. Jesus Christ. Oh my god, you guys. Please watch this afterwards. Okay, like... Oh god. Oh my god, that was terrible. I'm sorry, guys. Look it. I'm not here. Let me tell you something about gootecks, you guys. I'm not here to say nice things about you, okay? It's Sunday. This is the weekend. We're all putting in extra work here. Please bring your A game. Please work on your on the proper punishes. When you block, when Nakali throws out super and then you punish with your target combo into EX fireball and then you instead of doing tackle, like I get mad. That's my job. Look, man, I'm not here to tell you guys good job. I'm here to tell you guys when you fuck up, and I'm here to tell you guys how to get better. Please, please practice punishes against blocked supers. But hey, you know what? Always got to cheer for my boy Juan, representing from Chicago with that swanky Urian suit, business suit. Alright, so, we'll see. No uppercut on this side. I like the patience by Juan to sit back. Oh, random tackle. But, you know, the thing about the EX tackle is it is even on block. So, it's not like you're at a huge disadvantage for doing it. I don't know. Oh, nice conversion. Nicely done. Trillionaire with his back to the wall. About to head down to loser's bracket if he can't get it together here in this round. High stakes here at the cross counter training pilot student tournament. This is the first time we're doing this, guys. Thank you for joining us. Thank you to all the competitors for going heads up against each other. Thank you to Elon, who's been working behind the scenes to put this bad boy together. Please use V-reversal right there. Oh, wow. Hit him with the gimmicks. Oh, now you in the corner. Good blocks right there. No V-reversal. Okay. Basically, let's Trillionaire completely out of the corner. I really would have... I really don't like that use of Aegis right there. Is that an execution error? Is that a strategic error? Either way, it doesn't matter. It's not a poor choice. I mean, it's not a good choice, but it doesn't matter. Because Trillionaire just cracked under pressure, died with full V-trigger, full super, and you're still dead. Alright, so that means it is going to be Panties versus Chicago Classico in winners semifinals. Sorry, winners finals. Why does it say semifinals? I hate, dude, challenge is so stupid. Like, we don't call it semifinals. This is winners finals. And then next is grand finals. All right. But in the meantime, we're going to go down to the loser's bracket and see what's going on down here. The first match is likely to be Fedora Mike going up against Scolionage. Fedora Mike trained with Broly, and now is part of the Rise Up in Ranked video course. And he's been part of all of the group training sessions. Fedora Mike is the ripe old age of 12 years old. I was told that his father was the one that paid for the training sessions. As you can imagine, I mean, obviously a 12-year-old doesn't have a whole lot of income earning capacity. But his dad, shout outs to Big Papa Fedora Mike for investing in his son's future. I really, you know, things have changed so much since good old gootecks was 12 years old. When I was 12 years old, my dad would help me throw around the baseball at the park. But you know, this is the dawn of a new era, guys. We got 12-year-olds getting training for video games, esports, fighting games, Street Fighter V. Scolionage trains with Flo. He's Martin Porter from New York City. He says he wanted to start competing, going to locals and competing for fun. I don't have mad hours to plug into the game, but I definitely practice some and love playing people. I really like the fundamentals game, footsies and such, but I'm pretty bad at applying pressure with most characters. Well, I'll tell you what, Scolionage, Flo's student, going up against Broly Legs' student. So I'll tell you what, though. Scolionage, if you're listening, Fedora Mike has one weakness, which is patience. As you can imagine, as you guys probably remember from when you were 12 years old, patience is not a talent or a virtue that you had developed thus far that early in your life. Oh my god! The baits! Oh my gosh! Fedora Mike got his back to the wall, got a wake-up call! Oh my gosh! Scolionage, I really like what I'm seeing here. Very impressive way to start the first round. Oh no! Let him get too much breathing room. Fedora Mike forgot all about that secret. Oh my god, this setup was so dirty. Oh my god, I'm so stealing that. Stealing tricks and techniques from a 12-year-old. Yeah, we ain't too proud. Oh my gosh, dashing back and forth. Nicely done, Scolionage. Martin Porter from New York City. Let's go. Oh man. Oh no, no punish right there. Oh no, drops his combo, got too excited. Here comes Fedora Mike. All right, I'm gonna have a trip to the corner right here. Oh, I really like that sequence. Oh no, puts himself in the corner, goes for the EX command grab a little too soon. Now he's gonna back off and wait. Oh, can't count out Martin though, don't give him too much room to breathe. Now the fight's begun. Let's go. Keep him in the corner. Run the... Oh, yeah. All right. All right. Good stuff. Good stuff. Fedora Mike with a convincing second round, but Scolionage starting the third round with full meter. No punish right there on that splash. Oh, no. This could be it. This could be the beginning of the end for Scolionage. Yep. Corner. Party time. Nice conversion. Was kind of far from the corner, so had to go for the EX clothesline right there. All right. Now I want to see Fedora Mike back off a little bit. Okay, maybe he doesn't need to. Oh, no. Could have blocked that. The Stone Cold Stunner right there. Scolionage one hit away from Fedora Mike taking this to game two. Oh, very dangerous. Okay, she does get a setup after this. She is plus. Yep, she is plus. Oh my god, just a little too far to link into super right there. Oh god, that should have been uppercut. Oh, no punish there by Fedora Mike. This is coming down to the wire, guys. Patience. Okay, gets a knockdown setup. Yep, no need to go in too hard right there. Oh gosh. Oh wow. Oh my god, the empty jump into low. I don't know if you guys saw exactly what happened right there, but I believe Mike did EX clothesline on wake up. I don't know if Martin just knows this setup, but the crouching light kick hit the startup of the EX clothesline, which does not have invincibility on the first frame. Skolionage takes game one in a nail biter. All right, now I'll tell you what, guys. Fedora Mike has a propensity to jump. Yes. Yep. Nice bait right there. Ooh, mistimes the cross under. Now he's stuck in the corner, but it really doesn't matter. Mika doesn't care where she is on the corner as long as she's near you. Oh no, should have gone for EX Tatsu right there. Tatsu doesn't hit unless they're standing. Oh no, okay, all right. Oh wow, so I really like the usage of sweep here. Oh no, this is not good. One more opening is all it's gonna take. Ooh. Hits him with the crouching medium kick, puts him in the coffin, the mental damage. All right, but I really like how Skolionage always starts the second round with meter. Hits him on the tail end of that uppercut. That's fine. Good reversal right there. You can't throw fireballs like that. I'm going to see some V reversal right here to get out of the corner. Tries to check him. Oh no. Mike just so good at hitting the buttons at all the right times. Really tricky cross up right there. Baits the uppercut. Yeah, that's it. No teabag. Nope, just put him in the Cesaro swing. Tag in Nadeshko. Game over. All right, good adjustments there by Mike. I think Skolionage was still thinking about how he got away with murder in the first round. Now, here we are going into game three. One round apiece. One of these guys is going home, except they are already at home because we are playing online. All right. Now, as I mentioned, Mike does like to jump, and that's exactly what started the party in the last game. If you have enough time to parry, you probably also had enough time to uppercut. Yeah, that forward heavy punch is plus +3 on block. Such a good move. Uh-oh, maybe should have canceled into V-trigger. Tries to bait the uppercut right there. Yeah, I like the use of V-reversal right there. Oh my gosh! Oh, you don't see that very often. Smart stuff. Pretty good trade. Oh, nice cross-up. There we go. Yes, you have to use EX Tatsu right there because regular Tatsu will just whiff. Good blocks right there by Mike. Wow, very impressive. Skolionage one round away from having to watch turning this game off and going to watch SummerSlam. But no, he says, no, I'm not a fan of wrestling. Yeah, interesting. Actually, I think that's the first time that he's used command grab like that. Oh, no. But Mike wanted to cut the promo in the middle of the match. I don't know about that. The cockiness, I think, really got the best of him. Oh, wow. Puts him in the Marn. Haven't seen that one in a minute. Oh, my gosh. That was such a sick sequence. Big Papa Fedora Mike. Daddy is proud. Nicely done, son. Wow, what a sequence. We are going to have to watch a replay of that at some point. That was beautiful. Wow. Holy smokes, that was nice. Skolionage, well fought. It was a good match. But damn, Fedora Mike, 12 years old, Evo 2020. Evo 2024. Watch out. Fedora Mike is coming for you. All right, so next up, we're going to have Rekka Ralph going up against Mega Mouth. Rekka Ralph is Gary May from New York. Hold on, let's take a look at this bracket real quick, see where we're at. Rekka Ralph is Gary May, hailing from New York. He's a former competitive player raised on Street Fighter 1 and Street Fighter 2, and any fighters he could find growing up in New York City. Former top three finisher in upstate New York tournaments for Street Fighter 4, amongst other games. Played Guilty Gear XX, won tournaments around the East Coast. But now he's a grown-up with reduced playing time. Pondering the limits of a player, looking to adjust his game to his strengths and or reduce weaknesses. And he trains with Justin Wong, also a New York, also originally from New York, then moved to California, now living in beautiful San Jose, California. Justin Wong, also one of our trainers here at Cross Counter Training. If you're looking to train with any of these guys, all you got to do is go to crosscountertraining.com. Mega Mouth with a zero. Ken Urich, also from New York, Long Island specifically. He's a beginner Ryu player, super and ultra bronze. The local scene where he lives is really strong, and he's hoping after a few sessions and a lot of grinding, he can get comfortable enough to play with some of those guys. So, we'll see what happens. It looks like Rekka Ralph, let's see, who did he, he lost to Juan, Chicago Classico. And then in loser's bracket, he beat Shinjen. Then he beat Nogaremi, Eric Ellison. And now he's going to go up against Mega Mouth. Go ahead and ready up, guys. The clock. Shoot. There we go. The clock is ticking. Go, ready up, go, please. Ready up. Thank you, all right. Definitely some mismatches, you know. I mean, we got a fair amount of platinum players and then we got some bronze players, so I don't know, maybe we need to work out seeding. Like next time we're gonna do like rookie to silver, and then after that we'll do you know, gold and platinum, because definitely there is a skill gap. And you know, but you know, this is a learning process for everybody. So thank you guys for being a part of it. If you guys are just joining us, welcome to the first Cross Counter Training student tournament. This is something that we've been talking about, kicking around at the office for a while, but now it's coming to life. We want to thank you guys for joining us. If you guys missed it, the prizes for first place, we got prizes for first to eighth place. There are only 16 players total, so really all you had to do is make it to the second round. And, second round of winners and third round of losers. All right, so first place gets a four-session training package with the trainer of their choice. Third place gets one free session. The rest of third to eighth place gets subscriptions to crosscounter.tv, where you can check out shows like Excellent Adventures, as well as a multitude of training material, such as the Rise Up and Ranked video course. Nice conversion, except too far. Oh my gosh, these guys are swinging for the fences. Maybe need to be a little bit more conscious of the distance. Nice combo right there from Rekka Ralph. Oh no, gets the crush counter. Nice cross up, no conversion. These guys are battling for supremacy here in New York. It's so fitting that these guys would play on the New York stage. And that's gonna be the end of round one. Wreck-A Ralph from upstate New York, Mega Mouth from Long Island, New York. They're playing on the New York stage. We've got a New York hot dog. So Mega Mouth got a lot of bar to work with here. Nice uppercut. That's what I like to see. I want to see Mega Mouth use some of his bar, though, because if he doesn't use any of it, you might as well not have it. Good uppercut right there. Way to bait Wreck-A Ralph. Yep. Not safe to throw those sweeps out right there. Still working on a ton of bar. I would definitely like him to... Okay, if he hits him with a super combo, that was going to be the end of the round, most likely. Oh, no. Just stay on the ground and parry. Uh-oh. So, this is definitely a situation where not using your meter can definitely come back to haunt you. Now, what are you going to do? You got all this bar. Okay. No uppercut right there. Okay, there we go. Finally uses one of his bars. Now, on one hit away from dying. You know, guys, this is definitely one of the biggest things that separates bronze from silver and gold players, which is not being conscious with the resources of both you and the opponent on screen. And when I say resources, I mean V-gauge, critical gauge, life bar, stun bar, timer, screen position. Six resources of both you and the opponent to keep track of at any given time. How do you do that? Well, you make it a habit of constantly scanning around the screen to see, to always keep an eye on all of the resources that I mentioned. Wow, nice combo there by Wreck-A Ralph. Justin Wong would be proud. One round away from sending Mega Mouth home, except he is already at home. So I guess it'll be easy to start a cold shower and sit under the cold water like a Kermit frog. I don't know if you guys have seen that meme. Okay, please don't use all your bar here. Jesus Christ, he tried to use it all. This is what I'm talking about, guys. Like, it's a good thing that it didn't work, because if it did, he would have started the third round with no meter. Instead of hopefully putting away this round and starting with full bar, there we go, yes, full super. Wreck-A Ralph almost has full super. All it's going to take is one opening. Ah, okay. Both of these guys playing very patiently. I like the use of EX meter right there. Probably would have been a good idea for Wreck-A Ralph to cancel into super. Both of these guys need to hold it together. Don't go in too hard. Uh-oh. Jumping in for free. Okay, so first off, forward throw into dash is -2. So if you see a Ryu player do that, you can definitely hit a button. All the Ryu player can do after the forward throw dash is block low. That's it. But I don't think that Mega Mouth knew that. But now he does if he watches this replay. So now it looks like we are going to say goodbye to Mega Mouth. The Battle of New York has been decided. Wreck-A Ralph, who trains with Justin Wong. I think Justin would be proud to defend New York turf on the New York stage, and it looks like we're going to be going into losers round 4. This is losers semifinals, and it's going to be Nick Raba from Canada, and he is going to be going up. He trains with Alex Myers, and he's going to be going up against the 12-year-old prodigy Fedora Mike. Fedora Mike has been we're going to do winners finals first. Okay, so first off, we're going to go Panties versus Chicago Classico. Panties he's from Canada, Montreal, Quebec, and his name is on the tip of my tongue. Christopher Napolano. Trains with Flo, has done a bunch of KOF trials. he used to suck online, now not so much. So he used to do martial arts for years, 13 years in fact, then incurred an injury and it forced him to retire from martial arts. Now is putting all that fighting focus into fighting games. Obviously, martial arts far more physically demanding, but certainly some of this, many of the same principles in martial arts certainly apply to fighting games. Discipline, muscle memory, practice, understanding what the opponent wants to do, studying technique, all things that apply really to most everything in life, right? And the way that you do some things is the way that you do everything, as the saying goes. I'm actually kind of curious. I'm going to actually have a conversation with Flo about panties and see if we can learn more about him, see where he started from, because it seems like he started pretty low from his bio. And he's going to be going up against Chicago Classico from, you guessed it, Chicago. Juan Sandoval, one of our students in the Rise Up in Ranked video course. Oh no, spectating has been halted. Uh-oh. Okay, all right. Let's try this again. I'll go ahead and ready up and then pass it to these guys. Not quite sure what happened, you know. Yeah, Street Fighter, man. Street Fighter 5, still netcode, still a little buggy at times. All right, let's try this one again. And if you guys are just joining us, this is welcome to the tail end of the Rise Up in Ranked. Oh, sorry, the tail end of the cross counter training students tournament. This is the first time that we're doing this. Oh God, please. Okay, there we go. This is the first time we're doing this, but you know, hopefully this is just the beginning of one of many. And we're hoping that we can get the kinks worked out. All right, there we go.
Fight.
All right, Urien versus Cammy. So as I was mentioning, Juan is one of the students that we've been working with in the Rise Up and Ranked video course. He's been attending all the group training sessions, so I know he's actually been grinding it out, putting in hella work. Whoa, wow, nice block right there on that instant overhead. So tricky. Well, pretty convincing. Pretty convincing first round by Panties. So Juan usually likes to play kind of defensive, but he also likes to spend a lot of his bar on stuff like that he doesn't need to. All right. He's got a nice little life lead here. Ooh, interesting. I don't know if that was actually punishable. It looked like it was, but then he got uppercutted for his troubles. Okay, I would definitely not suggest letting her out of the corner like that completely. I mean, that was definitely a strategic error. Oh my God, I can't believe that worked. I saw that, I was like, I can't believe he didn't crush counter. That's not gonna work, and then it worked. Clearly, Juan knows something that I don't about this character, which is great. Oh my gosh, very risky. Oh no, this could be it. Okay, there we go. I like the use of V reversal right there. Yes. Okay, both players still very even. Oh my gosh, she still got hit by that. Okay, forward medium punch in the throw. Oh my gosh, what? happened there? That was crazy. I thought for sure Panties was taking that one. All right. Well, not gonna lie, I am cheering for one. Hey, look, you know, it's not my job to be unbiased, okay? It's not my job. My job is to tell it like it is. But, yeah, good. Oh, man. I think Juan has got his groove. Okay, so just so you guys know, and like I said, I'm here to tell it like it is. Forward medium punch is -2. Unless you hit it meaty on their wake up in the corner, it is -2. If a move is -2, then you should definitely hit a button afterwards. And when I say you, I mean you, the defender. That is not real. Guys, okay, so me and Flo are going to have a talk about teaching mental fortitude to the students. I'm just kidding. Panties, oh my gosh, Panties is one. Oh, it's done. One Chicago Classico in winners finals. Oh my god. I'm kind of hype right now. I'm not gonna lie. It was looking so free for Panties. Panties demolished everybody. But I think after that first game, he was on tilt. He couldn't believe that he lost that first game like that to a crush counter. I don't know what he did. I think he backdashed. Maybe he held up. I don't know. But that crush counter did mental damage. All right. Well, nicely done, Juan. I am impressed. That was really good. All right. So coming up next, in losers semifinals, we have Nickery going to go up against Fedora Mike. And then also in losers bracket, we got Trillionaire going up against Rekka Ralph. I will say, out of all these four players down here at the bottom, I do think Fedora Mike is favored to win, because nobody seems to know at this level how to fight Mika. And Fedora Mike has some beautiful setups, like we saw earlier. I mean, Nickery, very strong as well. But I think Nickery has a bit of a mental block against Fedora Mike. And yeah, if you guys are just joining us, we are coming down to the end of the cross counter training pilot edition of student tournaments. My name is gootecks. I'm sure you knew that, but in case you didn't, oops, that's not the right one at all, guys. I don't know who is controlling these things. Gosh. Okay, here we go. Fedora Mike versus Nickery. Fedora Mike from Houston, Texas, the ripe old age of 12 years old. If you're wondering how he even had the money to do any of this, to train or any of this, it's because Big Papa Fedora Mike, yes, his father paid for the lessons. You might say that is an unfair advantage. And I say, hey, look, you would do the same thing. 12-year-olds have no capacity to earn money, guys. But their fathers do, and I respect and appreciate that that Big Papa Fedora Mike, Papa Mike, if you will, has invested in his son's future in fighting games. I'll tell you what, Evo 2020, watch out. Fedora Mike is gonna be like 20 years old. Shit, even in like 4 years, this kid is gonna be a killer. Ah, yes. Fedora Mike. trying to. Oh yes, look at the damage on that throw after the V skill damage boost. These definitely add up. Nice anti-air. All right, Nikori gets a little bit of a lead right there. All right, now look, Mike is, oh my gosh, those young man reactions are so good. Dude, I tell you, it is so hard, in my opinion, to hit the, to use the V-trigger to punish Sonic Blooms like that. Dude, that is hard. And when I say young man reactions, I'm only half serious. A lot of you guys out there like to blame your success and failure on having bad reactions. But the thing about having good reactions is it's less about the reactions themselves and actually usually more about the anticipation. Oh no, doesn't get the full damage on that EX Sonic Scythe. Oh, Nikori lucks into some damage right there. Alright. Fedora Mike fighting back. Got a good lead. Gonna be patient. Nice. Oh no! Tries to cut the promo in the middle of the match. Gets a V-trigger combo for his troubles. But Fedora Mike does have full V-trigger. Mika can call Nadeshko. Here she comes. Oh, side switch. Hits the button a little too early right there. Fedora Mike's got a good lead, but if Nick can hit the super, it's definitely going to be game over. Oh my gosh, just runs through. Oh no, Nick hits the panic button. Not the first time we've seen him panic like that in this tournament. And Fedora Mike takes game one. Very close rounds. But I think that mental fortitude is definitely the area that Nick needs to work on in his game. You know, when Fedora Mike first started training with us in the Rise Up and Ranked video course, he just went balls to the wall. And then I said, look, kid, less is more. A patient Mika is so much scarier than a Mika that tries to go in hard all the time. And I think he's really taking that to heart. And I'm very impressed. Good blocks. Oh, man. See, the thing about that V-trigger is that if you use the same side option and it doesn't work, you are still in the corner. But he's out now. And Mike, very dangerous. Oh, wow. Oh, I've actually never seen that. Can you do that on reaction? Because that was godlike. Fedora Mike, the future? Oh, no punish right there. Nick has got to be kicking himself. Nice cross under. So sneaky. Ooh! Alright, finally, Nick gets one of these random supers and it works. Not exactly game-changing damage, but... Oh, okay, that's a nice conversion. Okay, yeah, alright. Good momentum. Okay, the momentum is over. Back away. Oh my gosh, same side again. That is such a tricky setup. Oh! Oh, wow! Fedora Mike saw that one coming. Says, no, you don't. Gotta watch out with these Sonic Booms. You can see Fedora Mike, he's plotting. Oh, what? That move is definitely plus two. I think Nick waited a little bit too long. But tell you what, not a bad showing there for Nick. I believe he's going home with fifth place finish. Yes, fifth place finish. Ties for fifth. Not bad. Not too shabby. So Fedora Mike moves on to losers semifinals. And next up, we are going to have Trillionaire from Sacramento, California. Philip Booker, I believe it was. Yes. So Philip Trillionaire claims to be broke. Says he's been wanting to improve as a player in Street Fighter and also know how to improve. He's been playing fighting games since he was a kid. Alpha 2, Sega Saturn, but only really tried to learn them for a few months after before Street Fighter 4 came out. Trained with me a little bit. And he's going to be going up against Rekka Ralph. Gary May from New York. Trains with Justin Wong, also a New York native. Gary was raised on Street Fighter 1 and Street Fighter 2 and any fighters he could find growing up in New York City. He's a former top 3 finisher in upstate New York tournaments for Street Fighter 4, amongst other games. Also played a little Guilty Gear, won tournaments around the East Coast. But he's a grown-up now with reduced playing times. So he's been looking at Justin to help him train and improve on his weaknesses. So now we got some even matches here. Trillionaire playing Nikali up in Platinum rank. And he's going to be going up against Rekka Ralph, also Platinum ranked Ryu player. I find this matchup to be pretty difficult as a Ryu player. I mean, Nikali, even though he doesn't technically have a projectile, his V skill definitely counts, and you can see right there, even if it trades, it actually definitely works out in Nikali's favor. Oh, no punish right there. Both these guys playing very safe. Okay, nice combo. Ah, I don't know about that cross-up right there. But Rekka Ralph doing a good job of maintaining this life lead. All right, now stuck in the corner. Going for frame traps is Trillionaire. Oh no, gets hit out of the V-skill. But he does have V-trigger now. Oh, there it is. One hit. Nice. Good conversion. Nice. Catches him hitting a button or not blocking. Who knows exactly what happened. Puts him in the coffin. Trillionaire Philip Booker from Sacramento, California takes game one. Excuse me. Round one. Or was it a prophecy? Can I see the future? Oh no, Rekka Ralph misses the uppercut right there. Gets sent to the corner for his troubles. Activates V-trigger. Gets out of the corner. Oh, super. Oh no. I guess he wanted to auto-correct it, but I guess he did it too soon. I don't know. Maybe he just tried to... I think what he just tried to do is try to auto-correct the DP. And I think he got super by accident. But now he does have V-trigger. I like that. Activate light, standing jab V-trigger. Oh no, going a little too hard right here. And that's going to be the end of round two. Very impressive showing from Rekka Ralph. Now, Rekka Ralph's got a slight meter advantage, but it kind of doesn't really matter too much because that's what matters. Trading fireballs with V-skill really works out in Nikali's favor because not only does he get the damage, but he gets the V-skill, he builds V-gauge from it. Both from taking damage from the fireball and from connecting with the V-skill. Now he's stuck in the corner. Tough place to be for Nikali. Really no way to get out. Okay, there we go. Alright, wake up V-trigger. Nope. Okay, there it is. I guess it was an execution error. Uh-oh. Rekka Ralph got a big lead right here. But if he's not careful, Trillionaire... Oh, jump straight into the uppercut. Gotta stay a little bit more patient. Game one goes to Rekka Ralph. If he wins this, he's gonna be going up against Fedora Mike. All right, so at this point, I would say that the turning points in the match were when that super came out by accident, the anti-air super. I don't think that was on purpose. But I want to see Trillionaire play a little bit safer and get more mileage out of his V-skill to build V-gauge in the early game. There we go, yes. When you get that knockdown, you can actually do it again to force them to block it again when they get up. And I only know this because I've been playing Nekali, I just learned how to play Nekali a little bit so that I could, make a video on learning characters by the frame data. And, oh, here we go. He's got V-Trigger. Wake up. Yup. Wait. Oh, man. So, Rekka, Ralph not doing a good job of respecting Nekali's wake up or timing the meaties properly. One or the other. Hard to tell. Oh, no. Got him to crack, though. Wow. Trillionaire definitely got to work on the defense there, man. Do not crack under pressure like that. Good rule of thumb. If you think it's a good idea to DP, don't do it. You should definitely uppercut at different times. If you think it's a good idea, it's probably a bad idea. Don't do it. Okay. Hard to say what that was supposed to be. All right. Let him just wear himself out. Oh, nice. Good conversion right there. Trillionaire's got a good life lead. Doesn't need to do anything too crazy. Should definitely spend a little bit of mental resources on trying to build up meter for the second round. But, okay, now he's got his back to the wall here. All right, there we go. The other thing, when Nekali is in V-Trigger, his V-Skill goes a little bit further and is a little bit faster. Oh my gosh. Rekka, Ralph on the verge of putting this away. Oh no, wow, that was, look how far he was. Okay, this is still match point for Rekka, Ralph. Gary May representing New York. Trillionaire, Philip Booker from Sacramento, trying to stay alive here in loser semifinals of the first of the pilot cross-counter training student tournament. All right. Good damage right there. Oh, wow. Gets the crush counter. Oh, man. It looks like Gary May. Rekka Ralph is on tilt. Option select. Jump forward out of the corner. All right. Let's see if Trillionaire can play safe enough. Patience is a virtue, guys. Like, you don't want to be going in too hard. I like his use of standing light punch. Oh, my God. Chooses not to super, probably a good idea right there. Oh my gosh, this is not looking good here. Oh my gosh, Rekka Ralph for the win. Rekka Ralph with that Justin Wong never give up attitude. I respect it. I like it. I'm so disappointed that Trillionaire let that one slip. He had literally a huge ass life lead. And I don't know. Like, in situations like that, it usually comes down to me thinking that if the player had a stronger neutral game, that wouldn't have happened. Like, if you can just recognize that you have a big ass lead, and if you just create space, back up, let them come to you, and run the clock, they're going to be forced to take ever increasing risks. Uh-oh, we got disconnected. Uh-oh. All right, hold on 1 second. Ah, okay. Gotta remake the room because now it's gonna be 3 out of 5. Oh my gosh. 3 out of 5 in losers? Oh man. We're gonna change that next time. Oh. That's okay. All right, here we go. So, losers bracket is losers finals is going to be 3 out of 5, and we're going to have Fedora Mike going up against Wreck-A Ralph representing New York City. So, like I was saying, like in those types of situations where you got a big ass lead and a lot of time on the clock, just take your time and chill. I mean, why even risk it? Because look, the timer is a resource. You may not think of it as one, but trust me when I say it is. So many resources in this game, and not all of them have bars. Let's take a look at this bracket, and let's try to look at the path that each of these players took to make it here. So, Fedora Mike actually lost in the first round against Panties, who's sitting pretty in Losers Finals. Oh, sorry, this is Losers Semifinals. So I still don't see... This still shouldn't be... I don't... Whatever. Okay. Okay, so look it. So Fedora Mike came from Alright, so Fedora Mike lost to Panties first round and then made it all the way back. He beat your good pal Jake. He beat Loco. He beat Scolionage. Then he beat Nikori. Now he's gonna try his luck.
Round one.
Against Wreck-A Ralph. And I tell you, this is one of Mika's hardest matchups, I believe. Anytime I gotta fight a Mika player in tournament, man, I'm going straight to Ryu. Well, that was convincing. Wreck-A Ralph playing on that home turf. Misses his uppercut right there. Fedora Mike playing very carefully. Okay, there we go. Picking his shots. Have a trip to the corner. Check out this hot dog. Wake up parry. Interesting choice. Generally, wake up parry does not work. Because it has a 3-frame startup. Okay, interesting information. I would say that now we know that Wreck-A Ralph likes to option select throw to escape having an attack on the ground or just blocking. So now Fedora Mike needs to take that information and put that one into the memory bank. Nice punish right there. There we go. Oh, there's a robbery going on. But Ryu doesn't care. He is focused only on the fight. Okay, so Fedora Mike slowly trying to lure Wreck-A Ralph to the corner. All he's going to need is one hit. V reversal? Yep. Smart stuff. Nice. Nice little shimmy bait right there. Block. Fedora Mike, one hit away from death. Oh, wow. Oh, my gosh! Ah, he went for the reset. Huh. You know, I don't know if the reset was the right thing to go for in that instance, because even if Wreck-O-Ralph didn't neutral jump, let's say he would have uppercutted, he would have done uppercut super, and then it would have chipped him, even if Fedora Mike would have blocked. So I would say that going for the reset right there was not the right decision, because he had full super and could have gone for the guaranteed damage instead. Alright, so Wreck-O-Ralph, oh man, what a conversion there by Fedora Mike. Oh wow, catches him throwing the fireball right there. Very convincing first round of the second game by Fedora Mike. Remember, these guys are playing 3 out of 5. Oh no, doesn't convert into super. There it is. Second time it is a charm. Now I would really like to see Wreck-O-Ralph focus on building bar for the third round. There we go. Here's the setup again. Oh, goes for another reset. Doesn't go for the same one as last time. Ah, puts himself in the corner, then goes for the command grab. Unfortunately, I think just not enough... not enough block stun on the cross-up light kick. Alright. Fedora Mike keeping the momentum on. There it is. Reset. Oh no, misses the Marn reset situation. Oh, we'll see. Oh, he gets another chance though. Doesn't go for the reset in that instance. Nice distance right there on the shoulder tackle, crouching heavy punch. Oh, wow. Beer reversal? No. Oh my gosh, one hit is all it's going to take. Goes for the overhead, but Wake Up EX Clothesline wins it for Fedora Mike. Remember, guys, EX Clothesline is not invincible on the first two frames. So that means that your meaty has to be timed perfectly, of which I would say that the overhead is pretty hard to do like that. Okay, so one game apiece, Wreck-O-Ralph versus Fedora Mike. Winner goes on to fight Panties in Losers Finals. Oh man, Wreck-O-Ralph with the anti-airs. Nice conversion there by Fedora Mike. So that move is I think it's -4, but if you hit it at the right distance, then you can combo, but only at the tip. Oh, same side. The mix-up was no mix-up. Oh my god, is this gonna be stun? One hit away. Oh, same side again. Fedora Mike looking super strong right now. Wow, Wreck-O-Ralph has gotta shake that one off. That one did a lot of mental damage. But yeah, like I mentioned earlier, Mike does have a propensity to jump quite a lot. And, you know, against fire... Oh, wow. Stun. Oh, my gosh. Get the bar. Don't... Okay. Yes. Yes. Smart. Yes. This is how we manage our resources. I like it. Don't even mess around. Like, that was the right combo to do... Oh, my God. Starting the third round with... Throwing a fireball, definitely the riskiest way that a fireball character can start, especially against a character like Mika, who really only wants needs one opening to put you in the corner. Super risky to start the round that way. Please don't do that. Slowly pushing Mika to the corner, but that's exactly where she wants you. I think think Mike's gonna try to cut a mid-match promo right now. Yep, there it is. Okay, now he's got V-Trigger. Now, it's about to be party time. Remember, he can hit those fireballs on reaction! Oh, but it... Oh, God, it was all for nothing! I'm not actually sure if the fireball has more or less recovery than Nash's Sonic Boom, but I will tell you... Oh, my God, wake up super! Whiffs. Mike cracked under pressure. Okay, see, this is the thing. Mika can definitely punish the fireballs on reaction with Nadeshiko V-Trigger. However, it's really hard. It's so hard. I would sit in training mode and try to do it. And I was just like, dude, if I hit it 1 in 10 times, it is not practical. And if something is not practical, I don't think it should be used in a high-pressure situation. So, now... Wreck-A-Ralph up 2-1. If he wins this, then he's going to be going up against Panties in Losers Finals. Nice tech right there. There it is. Puts him in the corner. Oh, wow. Wreck-A-Ralph was able to read that properly and uppercut, but then no punish. Not the proper punish on blocking EX clothesline. This tells me that Wreck-A-Ralph is not as familiar with the match as he could be. Because the problem with standing medium punch, crouching heavy punch, right up near the opponent, it's gonna whiff. Oh my God, again, not being conscious of the distance. Blows the entire super bar. Oh no. Mike missed his reset situation right there. Still kind of in a good position. Now, Wreck-A-Ralph, I would like to see him back away and try to build bar safely so that the next round can be... he can start with as much meter as possible. Oh my God, this is gonna hurt. Oh, I'm surprised. I'm actually kind of surprised he didn't jump tech. Oh my God, this could be it. Oh no, execution error right there. Oh my God, Mike steals this one. It is going down to the fifth game. Fedora Mike steals that one from Wreck-A-Ralph. Fedora Mike, of course, from Houston, Texas, 12 years old. Big Papa Fedora Mike, his father investing in his students' fighting game education. I respect it. And Wreck-A-Ralph, former top three upstate New York Street Fighter IV, a tournament placer. Now on his grown man hustle, trying to keep the younger generation down. We'll see what happens. Not the place you want to be against Mika. So dangerous. Gets the crush counter. Oh, nice set. Oh my gosh. That is such a sweet setup. Actually, I think that's the second or third time we've seen that today. I'm definitely stealing that. Crush counter sweep into empty jump low. Remembering that one. V-reversal. Yep. Oh, come on, Mike. You got to make those adjustments, buddy. Yes. Good use of EX Tatsu right there. Oh, no. Gets a little too close for comfort right here. One situation is all it's going to take to finish off Fedora Mike. Oh, match point. Wreck-A-Ralph. One round away from sending Fedora Mike home. I bet his dad is going to make him practice the rest of the night if he does not win this match. Yes, I like the usage of meter right there. Oh my God, catches him hitting a button. Go for the throw. Okay, good. Back away. Back away. Just back away. Back away. You're too close. V reversal. Okay. Oh, yes. Yes. Okay. Oh my gosh. So clean. Smart stuff by Wreck-A-Ralph. That is exactly what I would have done. I like it. Good stuff. Wreck-A-Ralph. Fedora Mike, that was a well-fought battle. Nicely done, young man. This kid has got a very bright future. And we're very proud to have him as one of our students here at Cross Counter Training, as well as the Rise Up and Ranked video course. Really at the end there, it came down to proper meter usage, and then, because after he hit him with the super, he basically tied it up. And then after that, he did a meaty axe kick, and Mike must have done something. He hit a button, or he backdashed, or he tried to wake up throw or something. But that counter hit really made all the difference. It was really at that moment that Mike had to sit and block. Maybe even, like, let's say, wake up V trigger, because even because you have one frame of invincibility, so you would get hit by the axe kick, but then the Deshko would come and, you know, the situation would be over. At least he wouldn't have been able to counter. That might have been the only thing he could have done right there. All right, so we are waiting. Go ahead and ready up. Okay, fine. Okay, there we go. All right, so it's gonna be Wreck-A Ralph from New York going up against Panties from Montreal, Quebec, Canada. Fucking ready up, god damn it. Fine, I'll ready up. Jesus Christ. Jesus fucking Christ. Like, I was gonna push him to the bottom. You fucking ready up? Alright. Alright, sorry guys. Miscommunication. Let me type in the Discord. Alright, tactical error on my end. I'm definitely not playing, don't worry, just kill me off. Okay. Okay, so we are coming down to the wire here. Let's take a look at the bracket and see. Let's see how we got here. It's go time. Thank you. Okay, here we go. So let's take a look at this bracket. Okay, so Panties beat Fedora Mike, who ended up getting fourth place, and then went up against Ratchis, beat Ratchis, then beat Nikori, who was playing Nash, and then lost to Chicago Classico in a nail biter. Man, it definitely didn't look like it was going to go down that way at the beginning. And so Wreck-A Ralph lost to Chicago Classico, who's sitting pretty up in the grand finals. And after that, he beat Shingen, then he beat Noga Remy, then he beat Mega Mouth, then he beat Trillionaire, then he beat Fedora Mike. Wow. What a day it's been here at the Cross Counter Training Beta Student Tournament. I'll tell you what, this match is difficult for Ryu. I always found. I mean, certainly not impossible though. Definitely not. I mean, but it just seems like Cammy has all the tools to get around Ryu's fireballs. And that's so hard to deal with. If you block her V-skill, I mean, she's plus after that. Yep, that's the end of round one. These guys are playing first to three, 3 out of 5. Winner advances to grand finals, where they will have to beat Chicago Classico in 2 sets of 3 out of 5 in order to take this one home. Oh no, that is... I don't know about parrying that, man. Ooh, nice bait right there. Oh no, wasn't able to capitalize. Oh, there we go. Now I think Wreck-A-Ralph has got a handle on what to do about that EX Hooligan. I think backdash is a better idea than trying to challenge it straight away. Yeah, just walk. Yeah, there you go. Advance forward. Yes, there you go. Good old wake up jab. The bane of Street Fighter V's existence. All right, convincing performance by Panties. Game one. I wonder if Panties had taken the time to watch his losses back against Chicago Classico and see what he needed to tighten up. Meanwhile, Wreck-A-Ralph has gone through a gauntlet in loser's bracket. Yes, good gray life damage right there. Not able to convert, but still, I like that block string from Ryu. That's a questionable punish. But hey, now she's in the corner, so I guess it wasn't that bad. Man, I think next on my list of characters to learn out of, just to reach competency, is definitely Cammy. Like, if you guys don't know how to play all the top tier characters, you definitely, it's a good usage of time, in my opinion. Not because you need to be the best with them, just to reach competency. Because they are strong characters, and they're very common characters. Okay, Wreck-A-Ralph, up one round. Oh, what a sneaky cross under that was. But it looks like Wreck-A-Ralph, he's not dead yet. Still in it. Okay, alright, well, start the third round with full bar, plus she used one bar. So now, if you get one opening to land super, it's totally worth it, and then... Yeah, I definitely want to see him... I mean, right now, Cammy's options are pretty limited. Okay, well, not anymore. I mean, now she can go through EX fire, through fireballs with the, cancel into super. Okay, all right, now. Yeah, there you go. Sit back. Don't go in too hard. Build meter. Play safe. Yes, yes. This is how you play after you have a big life lead in the third round. After you use all your bar. Yes, good. Okay. Yeah, there you go. Take your... Oh my god! God, that was sick! Oh! Oh, man, that was sick. That has got to do some mental damage right there. Panties has got to think about that one. Put that one in the memory bank. Ooh, that is brutal. All right, so one game apiece. These guys are playing a first of three. Wreck-A-Ralph is dealing that mental damage. On the verge of stun. Yep. Good combo right there. Builds a lot of bar. No need to spend any. Okay. Got the helmet on Ryu now. Okay. I like Panties being a little bit more patient. Both of these guys know it's kind of high stakes now, you know? Got Cammy right where he wants her. Oh no, now she's out. Good life lead. No need to go in too hard right here. Oh no, converts into super. All right, good stuff. But Cammy very dangerous, on the verge of getting full meter. Whoa, no you don't. Slightly faster recovery on the fireballs. Doesn't spend the super. Oh, how about that? How about a wake up jab of my own? A taste of your own medicine, Panties. How does it feel? Tell me. Tell me how it feels right now. Yes, there we go. Respect the uppercut. Both players not taking big risks. Smart. Yep, good use of EX Fireball right there. Oh no, went in a little too hard. Maybe it would have been better to sit on the lead a little bit. Oh no, EX Hooligan into the slide. That's the only move that gives her plus three. Oh gosh. Oh my god. Oh, what a conversion! Panties hit the panic button. It seems as though we have discovered that Panties has a mental fortitude weakness in his game. You know, in his bio, Wreck-A-Ralph, Gary May, had mentioned that he was a top three finisher in upstate New York tournaments in Street Fighter 4. I believe that this real life tournament experience is coming in handy now. Oh, Panties is on tilt. This is the same thing that happened to Panties when he fought Juan. Oh my gosh, it's done. Stick a fork in Panties. He's done. Recognizing that you are on tilt is the first step to recovering from being on tilt. Now, I mean, Wreck-A-Ralph he doesn't need to go in this hard. He's got a lot of bar to work with. I like that use of one bar right there instead of blowing super. Oh, wow. That was such a... Oh, my gosh. I can't believe that happened. Okay. Oh, Panties is going crazy, though. Look at that gray life. Okay. Buys himself another round. Okay, I think he has recovered from being on tilt. But Wreck-A-Ralph starts the third round with full super. But Panties has one bar, which means that it's going to be very risky for Wreck-A-Ralph to throw fireballs. But maybe not. Maybe that's what he wants. Maybe he wants him to use his bar. Okay, all right. So he uses it. Now Wreck-A-Ralph can go back to throwing a fireball game. Okay, that's good. No need. Yeah, all right. Oh, there's that setup. There's that setup. I'm totally stealing that. I learned something today, guys. Oh my god, that was so sick. The reversal. Oh, same thing. Same situation. Oh my god. How does he know? Oh, the desperation. He had to overcome right there. The old Panties is still in it. Oh my god. Oh. Wreck-A-Ralph. Gary May from New York sends Panties home. Panties was in winners finals. He looked like the clear favorite to take this. But then he ran into Wreck-A-Ralph. Oh, wow. That was so impressive. Now it's going to come down to grand finals. Chicago Classico. Chicago Classico versus Wreck-A Ralph. Whew, man. What an impressive performance by Wreck-A Ralph. I think when Justin Wong hears of the news of his student's success, he will be so proud. Okay, so now let's take a look at Chicago Classico's run to grand finals. We have his first match. Oh, look at that. The run back. Chicago Classico's first match today was against Wreck-A Ralph. He beat him, sent Wreck-A Ralph to losers. Then Wreck-A Ralph had to go through all kinds of guys. Let's see, he beat Shinjin, he beat Noga Remy, he beat Mega Mal, Trillionaire, Fedora Mike, and then finally Panties. Chicago Classico beat Captain Grady, Trillionaire, then he beat Panties after Panties cracked under pressure. And now, grand finals, he's going up in the run back, Wreck-A Ralph. All right, can we ready up, please? Please, can we ready up? Okay. If you guys are just joining us, you are just in time for the grand finals of the pilot edition of the Cross Counter Training Student Tournament Series. Thank you guys. Thank you to all the competitors for playing today. Thanks to you guys for watching on the Facebooks. That's right. Are we streaming this to Twitch? Nope. Are we streaming it to YouTube? Nope. Because we're keeping it on the low. Don't tell anybody. And thanks to Elon, who's been working tirelessly all day putting this together. Thank you, Elon, for helping to push this idea forward. I'm having a great time. And I hope you guys are too. We're going to do more stuff like this, I believe. Feel free, send us your comments and suggestions for what we can do to make this better. Better all around. All right, so these guys are playing 3 out of 5. Wreck-A Ralph must win 2 sets of 3 out of 5 in order to win the tournament because he's in loser's bracket. Chicago Classico Juan Sandoval must only win 1 set of 3 out of 5 because he's in winner's bracket. All right, so pretty good, pretty strong start here by Chicago Classico. I'll tell you what, I really don't like this match as a Yurian player, but Juan actually really likes it. So we didn't stream the first match, the first round of matches, so I don't know how Wreck-A Ralph versus Chicago Classico went. Oh no. Good blocks right there. All right. It was a strong start from Chicago Classico. And then towards the end of that round, started to get a little shaky. Now, Wreck-A Ralph starting second round with full meter. Good position to be in. I still don't like how Chicago Classico always uses his bar on arguably random hits. Because then he doesn't have enough bar to finish off his opponent in that situation. Ah, sorry, my footage is... okay, there we go. Alright, so Chicago Classico. Juan Sandoval from Chicago takes game one pretty convincingly.
Round one.
All right. And of course, Wreck-It Ralph loves to play on the New York stage. Trained by Justin Wong, also a New York native. And yes, this is definitely not the position that you want to be in as a Urien player. You don't want to fight, you don't want to let Ryu play his game. You don't want to let him set up shop with the fireballs. Oh, please throw him to the corner next time. Oh, okay. Okay, thank you, Wreck-It Ralph. I try to tell Chicago Classico that these random EX knee drops aren't actually that good, but finally, somebody has stopped him from getting away with it. Oh, that's a... Oh, I like that lockdown. That's good. It's not enough, though. Not enough. And, hey, you know, Wreck-It Ralph always very conscious of the way that he spends his bar, and now starts the second round with full meter, and Chicago Classical has none. Okay, well, now he has one bar. Okay, fine. But still. Yep. All right. Now, I want to see him stay back, try to build bar safely. Yes. Good. Good. Sit back. Chill. He's even on... Okay, so EX Tackle is zero on block. So it's not exactly risky. It's not risky for Urien to throw out. But afterwards, you should definitely hit a button. Because Urien doesn't have a three-frame normal. Okay. Yep. Okay, no way to view reversal right there. Oh, that would have been a good time to hit a button afterwards, after blocking the solar plexus. Oh, nice conversion. Oh, wow. Oh my gosh, Juan is so close to taking this, but the momentum is over. It's not much. Oh, wow. Wreck-It Ralph went in a little too hard right there, but he does start the third round again with almost full super. All it's going to take is one opening right here. Whoa, nice punish on that fireball right there. Juan getting a lot of mileage off of the knee drops. Oh man, that forward medium punch. I swear to God, it's minus two. You guys just don't know because you don't play Urien, but I swear it's not that good. Nice, nice, nice conversion right there. Oh man, Juan's got some good momentum here. Okay, the momentum is over. Ryu's still very dangerous. V-trigger and full super. Is that going to work? Yes, it is. Right distance. Wake up V-trigger. Oh, yes. I like it. I like it. You don't actually see wake up V-trigger with Urien that often, but it actually is really good unless they're right up next to you. Then they can just throw you out of it. But if they're not right up there, you can throw it out for free. Now, Juan is one game away from sending Wreck-It Ralph, Gary May from New York, sending him home. He already is home though, so it's not a long way to the kitchen. Eat your feelings away. That's what I do. Every time I lose a tournament, I just eat my feelings away. But it's not over yet. These guys are playing 3 out of 5. Remember guys, Wreck-It Ralph must win 2 sets of 3 out of 5 because he's coming out of loser's bracket. Juan Chicago Classico only needs to win one more game to put Wreck-It Ralph away and win a free 4-session training package with a trainer of his choice. Oh no. Execution error right there from Wreck-It Ralph. All right. Oh, no EX headbutt right there. Oh no, oh no. Oh, wow. Yeah, that V-trigger, when Ryu is in V-trigger, if he does super and the opponent blocks, it does cause a guard break state. But you don't actually get that much time, so it kind of only works that way in the corner. So that was very good screen awareness by Wreck-It Ralph. Wreck-It Ralph. Got a good start to this game. Good punish, yep. Not safe to tackle like that. This is not third strike. Nice, good bait. Wreck-It Ralph taking game 3. The score is now 2-1, Chicago Classico. Very convincing second game there. And it's like, basically if Wreck-It Ralph can play the standard Ryu game and not let Juan get the momentum going, it's pretty clear who wins. But I think because Wreck-It Ralph is not super familiar with the Urien matchup, that's why Juan is able to, once he gets the momentum going, that's why he's able to get a lot of mileage out of, you know, different situations. Oh no. Oh my gosh, this is not looking good, guys. Oh my gosh, Juan is on tilt. Okay, convert into Aegis. Oh, woo! Woo! Man, that is a hard reset to do. Didn't quite pay off. I don't like the use of using Aegis right there. I mean, you really need it later on. You get so much time that you can use it. So there's no reason to use it right away after you pop the second one. See, like right there, you could have used it right there. Instead, you burned it too early. But okay, I don't like the use. Oh my gosh! Do not attack him. Oh god. Oh. What? What? Okay, Juan is one round away from putting away Wreck-It Ralph, but he doesn't have any bar to work with, and Wreck-It Ralph is not having any of this knee drop shit at all. That's like the third or fourth time that he went for a knee drop and got uppercutted for his trouble. Oh, nice shimmy right there. No, come on, you gotta convert those low jabs into tackle damage. Okay, very risky to attack right here. He's got, okay, forward medium punch, I swear to God, is plus two, guys. I would not lie to you. Now would be a good time to use Aegis, though. I would definitely, oh man. Okay, all right, that's not that bad. It's not that bad, but it's also not that good. Duh. Okay, if Wreck-It Ralph wins, I'm calling it now, he wins the entire set. Juan is definitely on autopilot. This is why I say, this is why I think that the match is difficult, the Ryu match is difficult for Urien. Because if Urien doesn't get that early momentum, and then Ryu is just able to basically set up shop with the fireballs, then Urien really struggles. V reversal, please. Oh god. Okay, this could be it. Okay, I like how he backed off. Okay, if you're gonna back off, just back off. Don't back off and then go right back in. Do not knee drop. Okay, that doesn't, that just, it's just not that good. Like, look it, it's the second time. It's not good. You can't just throw Aegis out like that. It's useless like that. This is your biggest asset as a Urien player. Please use Aegis effectively. Not when you have your back to the corner unless you're about to die. Like, you think you're about to die, but there are actually so many situations that you could have used Aegis on instead of just throwing it out raw like that. All right, this is it. If Juan wins this game, it's the end of the tournament. Juan wins. If Wreck-It Ralph wins, the bracket is reset, and they play another set of 3 out of 5. Okay, so Juan's got a good lead right here. Yeah, don't forget about Urien's fireballs. Okay, back in the corner. I'll tell you what Wreck-It Ralph is not doing basically ever is using wake up uppercut, which, I mean, you gotta do sometimes. I know we are risk averse, but sometimes it is necessary. Okay. Juan is on tilt right now. But hey, you know what? He had such a big life lead. Oh my god, why? Why? Why do you do that? Look at that's this. Okay, there we go. Finally, third time's a charm. That's the third time he did raw Aegis, then did V-Skill, then did that fireball, and actually had that work out, finally. If your strategy or setup works 1 out of 3 times instead of 2 out of 3 times, like, you need a better approach. Yep, not safe. Yep, good use of bar right there. Use it in the early round. Build some bar. Don't go in too hard. Oh my gosh, that was definitely an execution error right there by Wreck-It Ralph. Okay, I want to see him build bar. Uppercut? No, no uppercut? Okay. Yeah, see? That's what I'm saying. I told you, forward meat, Urien's forward medium punches -2 is not that good. You should definitely hit a button afterwards. All right, match point. Okay, not match point, but bracket point, let's say. So, if Chicago Classical wins this round, he wins first place in the tournament. If Wreck-It Ralph wins this round, the bracket is reset and we go to a second 3 out of 5. Okay, Urien stuck in the corner. Okay, good headbutt right there. All right, nice life lead. Okay, Wreck-It Ralph keeps running into these. Yep, there we go. The adjustment has been made. I told you guys. I like the patience. If Juan loses this, it is. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, that was so close. Went for the throw a little too early. He was still in block stun. Yeah, okay, so the problem with the second Aegis is that it takes forever to come out. Oh my god, ran into the surprise headbutt. Runs into the surprise headbutt, gets the throw. Oh my gosh. Okay, hold on, let me see. Let me see if we can get an interview. Oh, wow. All right. Okay, hold on. Congratulations. Okay, all right, how do we do this? How do we do this? Sorry, guys, I'm a... Okay. Okay, hold on 1 second. Let me just mute the game real quick. Okay. Juan, can you hear me? Hold on 1 second. 1 second. Check, check. Juan, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you, bro.
Oh, there we go. Awesome. First off, congratulations. That was a nail biter at the end, man. But you came through in the clutch. How does it feel?
Dude, I finally won an online tournament.
How many online tournaments have you played in?
I was in 2 at the same time right now, actually. I just got bopped by Broly Legs on the last one I'm in. But, man, like, I don't know. I've been practicing a lot. It feels good.
Nice. Well, it looks like it's been paying off. You know, obviously, we all have some improvements. You know, we can always improve. But what would you say was, like, What do you think was like the turning point in the match? I mean, there was like, what were you thinking when he won that second game?
I was like, Jesus Christ, like, I'm already up two, man. Like, I'm about to lose this. I had to like take a couple seconds and just think, like, man, what the hell am I doing? And so like I tried to like slow it down, and man, that last grab was just pure luck, bro. I'm not gonna lie, that shit was,
Well, hey, it worked, and congratulations. I think it all went really well. So you win first place. You win a four-session training package with a trainer of your choice. Who would you like to train with?
Man, I'm still debating. I don't know. Like,
oh, okay. Well, I mean, there's no rush. There's no rush. Like, you just tell me later. Think about it. I was just, you know.
Yeah.
But yeah, man. Hey, congratulations. The practice is paying off. I know that can you talk a little bit about how the monitor that you used to play on versus what you're playing on now?
Yeah, like 122 milliseconds lag delay I was on before. I don't know how I got a plan on playing like that. And then I did the first session with you. I went online on like OfferUp. I found a BenQ for like $100 and I've been playing on that now, and it's just night and day, man.
Awesome. Well, hey, congratulations. Good investments. Cool. Well, I'm going to jump off here and wrap up the stream, but congratulations. Super excited for you. It was a close call, but hey, you came out on top. So congratulations, Juan.
All right. Thanks again, man. I appreciate it.
No problem, dude.
Everybody, I had fun.
Anybody you need to shout out?
Oh, man. Just all you guys for helping me out.
All right, cool, man. All right, talk to you soon, Juan.
All right, then.
All right, later. All right. Well, hey, it was a success. Nobody died. Nothing caught on fire. We did it. Well, I want to thank all the players, all 16 players that competed, all the students that competed today. Thank you guys for helping us out and, you know, showing us what we can do better. Hopefully this is something that you all enjoyed. Thank you guys for watching. I hope it was fun to watch. I know it was just me here, whatever. But you know, it's only gonna get better from here. I'm going to stop the recording and then upload it. That way everybody can watch it. And of course, thanks to Elon for putting all this stuff together. I think it went really well. If you guys got feedback, please post it in the Facebook group or send me an email or send an email to info@crosscountertraining.com. If you want to unlock your potential in the same way that so many of these students are doing, including Juan, who won this today, you can go to crosscountertraining.com and train with some of the strongest players in the business. You can also go to riseupinranks.com, which is the brand new video course that we launched. And that's where a lot of these players came from as well. So thank you guys so much for watching. My name is gootecks. Hit me on Twitter. Follow me there. Follow me on Instagram. Thanks for watching. See you later.